Welcome everyone to the ADV Orlando channel, where riding on two wheels is always an adventure. And today we're going to be in Oregon County, recording a few roads and redoing some things that we did in the past.
You ever been here before?
No.
Low Water Bridge.
I saw that squirrel was trying to do the Geico commercial.
Well, I'm telling you, man, he wouldn't move.
Once again, here in Morgan County, I'll be relying on my tour guide, Jeremiah, and his internal GPS for this county. I really don't know it that well, but it's definitely worth learning to ride, and I'm going to ride as much as I can. And also, we plan on going up to Cacapon State Park to swap bikes. I want to ride the KLR up the rough area that I rode the Vstrom last time to give me a pretty good beating. And Jeremiah is going to ride the Vstrom up to the Overlook this time. And we'll both talk about how the experience was and how the bikes are different. Else that I plan on doing this time also would be to put little captions down there on the road that I'm traveling on. That way, as you watch the video, you actually can, you know, familiarize yourself with the road, where it's going to go, and hopefully that would help me learn also. Valley opens up on this road, it reminds me of a view as I was heading north away from Seneca Rocks towards Elkins, West Virginia, and really does give a mini testament to the beauty of Mac State, West Virginia.
Thank you.
This isn't a single track like I thought it would be. It's more like a maintenance road for the trucks here on, at the park for maintaining things. And it must have been that water tower was part of that. But yeah, we rode this before and we didn't get to record it. But it's a little bit challenging. It's not that hard. You got the rain ruts that are kind of the only challenging part. And with the Vstrom, I have to be careful. But you can see Jeremiah is gliding right over him like it's nothing.
Thank you very much.
I hope to take this gadget with me every time I ride bikes now, because biking and riding and adventuring are all pretty much part of, you know, discovering some nice remote and beautiful areas. And the only thing that really can add more than a motorcycle would be a drone. So the drone is something that I'm going to get better with. I'm going to use more often. I hope you enjoy seeing what it produces.
When I shoot around them?
Yeah.
I'll try it first.
going on right here is we were getting ready to go up the to the overlook. We got stuck behind two very slow moving vehicles, and we don't want to sound impatient, but going slow on a steep climb and difficult terrain can be really tricky for you when you're on two wheels. So we're going to get around them to where we can tackle these things at our own pace. Now I'm instantly reminded of getting jarred and beat up on this road the last time I climbed it, but this time I'm on the KLR and I'm ready for the challenge, and already I'm aiming for the worst places in the road that you can hit, and I'm not really feeling hard in any. The suspension is doing a really good job of soaking up a lot of the hits, and that makes it easier to control too. On the flip side, watch the windshield on the Vstrom in front of Jeremiah. You'll see it shaking around a good bit. He gets stuck in a rain rut too. You hear the rattling that goes on. That's what I was going through the last time we went up the hill. Jeremiah wound up taking the lead the rest of the way like I did last time also. And so he's looking forward to a nice serene scene like we've got here rather than that rough ride coming up that hill.
Okay, this is enough. This is awesome. I can't believe how nice and smooth this thing takes it. I just know I know exactly what you're going through back there.
Oh, it's just beating and rattling. I mean, it's got the power, man. It comes up just fine.
You wanna switch bikes or just head down?
I was thinking let's head down there and let them slowpokes get up here so we don't have to try to go around them going back down.
I'm back on the Vstrom and riding downhill. I'm not having that bad of a time because I'm first, for one thing, and there's no dust blocking my view. Plus, I think that just everything in general is a bit easier to do once you go downhill rather than trying to climb up. And always remember to ride what you have whenever you can, wherever the road takes you.